In this demo, we are going to create an SMS flow to handle and route SMS messages. Before we begin an SMS creation flow, it is very important that you have at least a single media file defined in your tenant. Now, this media file is not going to be used in a real life play. In other words, if you have a hold music media file that you're using, it's not like we're going to play hold music on an SMS message. It's just that there is a flow requirement to specify at least one of the media messages in the flow defaults. And so you have to make sure you've got at least a single hold music message in your platform. At the same time, it's also important to make sure you've got a queue to route your SMS interactions to. So making sure you've got at least one media file on your tenant and that you have at least one queue defined are prerequisites for using the flow example we're going to show you today. So to create a new SMS flow, I'm going to go ahead and create a tutorial SMS flow. Now, you obviously would name this whatever you want to name it. I'm just picking the name to match what we're doing here. And you're going to select the flow type as customer. Then when you hit submit, a new empty flow is created. Once the empty flow has been created, we can go through and start to populate it. Now again, every flow must have an entry and an exit point. So let's start by dropping an entry point into our flow. SMS queue routing does not have to be very complicated. You can do more fun things like auto replies or whatnot, but for purposes of this, we're going to build a very basic flow where I'm going to take any SMS received messages and route them to a queue. So I'm just going to go ahead and drop this in a particular SMS queue here. And again, this is where we have to specify that hold music I talked about earlier, where it's just important to have a file there. Obviously, we're not ever going to play any hold music in response to an SMS message, but it's just something that the flow itself looks for. And likewise, when you see this resource field, I'm just going to type in the word agent. And what this is doing is whenever the queue finds an agent to handle this SMS message, this queue step progresses onward and this value of resource is bound to the agent ID that called it. So that's where that ends up coming from. All right, after we have our queue with media step, we're going to have to conference the SMS message into the agent so the two of them can be tracked together. You'll notice that we do have an option for recording or not recording an SMS message. We can record SMS messages. We can record them as a text transcript that will be available in the historical reporting engine. So this will work if you hit the record button because we will record SMS messages. And then just go ahead and drag that arrow to the right. Now briefly on this whole arrow dragging process, if you have not done it before, just going to go ahead and reconnect and touch on a couple of points here. To create an arrow, you click on a box, you hover over that arrow that points to the right, you left click and drag to connect the box. You can move an arrow around. So if I click anywhere out in the middle of the arrow, I can click and drag and redraw and move it. If I don't like what I do, if I perhaps think this is not how I want the arrow to look, I can hover over the bend there until I see that little black X. When I click that, the arrow reverts to normal behavior. And also, if I hover over, if you created an arrow that you can't easily delete or other concerns like that, you can hover over any of these lines and hit the red X and the arrow will disappear. So just being mindful that that's how we work with connecting these boxes if it's not something that you have done before. After we conference the customer in, it's always good to leave a disconnect step. So when the customer leaves the conference, either because the agent leaves or because the interaction is disconnected by the agent, this step will continue on. And a disconnect step is just a reminder to the system that they can freely clean up, if you would, the interaction. And note that when you do disconnect, you're just going to disconnect the customer leg of the call here in that case. And then at the very end, we're going to drop an exit step. So this is all that is required to take an SMS message, drop it into a queue, conference it with the agent once we've identified the agent, and then eventually disconnect it at the bottom when the interaction is finished. Now it is important to include some settings for the agent in this process. It is possible to have a very detailed set of operations that you can really carefully map out using the resource entry step and all sorts of stuff. For purposes of this demo, I'm just going to drop the basic resource flow in. And what resource flow says is when an agent is chosen, what settings should we offer to the agent? So I'm going to go ahead and maybe say that I give the agent 60 seconds to respond to an SMS message. I'm going to ask the agent to be forced into auto wrap up, and you can change if you want. If you want to require dispositions on this SMS message, you can specify that here. If you want to specify that they have 30 seconds where you're trying to get them to wrap up a call, but you'll give them up to 120 seconds to complete wrap up, you can configure that, as well as auto screen popping or not inside the system. So just kind of keep in mind that when you're looking at this resource flow scenario, that there is a lot of operations that go on in here. You can reconstruct that manually using the resource entry step if you want, but by no means do you have to. Now, at the same time, you can't publish this flow quite yet. If you were to hit publish, you'll get a note that says, oh, by the way, you have to complete the platform defaults. So if I go ahead and close that out and I click on this little gear icon next to it, you'll notice that there are some settings in here that are flagged as red, and that's just because the flow expects to see some kind of value there. So again, you're not going to play hold music, but just on the off chance that somehow a phone call got into this flow, which it never should, and you wanted to play hold music, the flow asks you just to specify this as a safeguard. On the transfer timeout, this is how long it would take a call to timeout when an agent is transferring it to another agent or to an external phone number. And again, if you didn't want to specify the target wrap-up time and max wrap-up time, these are just kind of safeguards inside the system for specifically for transfer activity that's not tied to the agent activity themselves. So once those changes are done, then you should be able to publish this flow. And when you publish it, go ahead and name it whatever you want to name it. I'm going to call it initial flow. And I'm going to make this the active version of the tutorial SMS flow. So at this point, this will be, if you call the tutorial SMS flow, that is the version of the flow that will show up as active. And oftentimes, even after you create a new flow, it's a good idea to come in and make sure the flow itself is marked as an active flow. Because if it's not marked as active, you're going to have a hard time trying to assign it to the dispatch mapping, which will be the next step we're going to do in our system, is to bring it into the dispatch mapping here. So just to sort through, this is a large tenant with a lot of different flows. Tutorial SMS flow has been created. It is active, as you can see here, and it has a published version that is also active. Now, if you wanted to configure a phone number to reach this flow, that's very straightforward. You go from flows and you click on dispatch mappings. When you do, the dispatch mapping menu will come up, and you can, if you wanted to, create a new SMS mapping for this particular flow. So I can say hit create, and I'll call this tutorial SMS mapping, and I'll assign this as an SMS interaction type. This is going to be a contact point mapping, meaning that I'm going to route SMS messages to a particular contact point in my system. And you put the number of the phone number that you want to receive SMS messages from. Keep in mind, of course, that your SMS provider has to route these messages to CXEngage. But once they come to CXEngage, this is how we work with those. And then at the very end, you go ahead and select the particular SMS flow that we have created, and then you are able to route that directly into the platform.